And now I'm ready to do exactly the same thing to this side. Now comes the part for the center drill. And this is, we'll be using the same type of drill that was used on the engine bearings. Again, it's just a very stiff drill that starts a pilot hole. It won't wander. So put that in. Bring this up on the tailstock. Tighten everything down. And I'm going to start drilling the hole for the axle. Now, I'm going to do the same thing on the base of the engine. We've got our pilot hole started. I'm going to go back with the 15/16 drill, or 15/64 drill. There's a method of drilling, I'll stop just a minute. There's a method of drilling called peck drilling. Peck drilling is what the name implies. You go in, pull out, go in, pull out, go in, pull out. There's a good argument, I think, that you can make to keep the drill bit from wandering so much, even though it shouldn't, on something like this, and I'm using a very sharp drill bit. I don't want to risk the any wandering that might go on. So you're going to see me go in and pull it out from time to time, even though this is only going through about a half inch of metal. By the way, the oil that I use on almost anything, I've tried lots of different cutting oils. I've tried all kind of what they call whey oils, which is how you lube the lathe bed. And you can spend as much money as you want to on that. I have really found out that if I go to Walmart and buy the full synthetic oil, just the Walmart brand of synthetic oil, the equivalent of Mobil 1, it works really well for 95% of all cutting I do on virtually any metal. And for whey oil, for protecting the lathe bed, I use chainsaw oil. And I've been doing it for years, have not experienced any wear whatsoever, so I'm comfortable with those two. Now it's time to start the reaming process. Now I've oiled the reamer up very good. If you recall from the milling machine video, reamers require lots of oil. Now reamers, I will not be doing any pecking like I did on the drill a while ago. The reamer goes in, goes right back out. And it is reamed. Come back. I like to clean off all my tooling before I put it back up. Just brush off the metal chips. There it is, sitting on the layout block. And let's give it a spin. And we'll see how she runs. And I think overall, it's running pretty darn straight. I think that'll meet expectations there. That kind of bad spot makes it look like it's got a wobble in it, but it really doesn't have a wobble at all. Nope, it is running straight. See you on the next video.